Hello friends, let us now learn some important points about the some previous year questions. First question, all of the following are included in aggravated penetrative sexual assault. Aggravated penetrative sexual assault under POSCO Act, except gang rape, yes, and during communal or secular violence, if there is sexual assault, then that comes under POSCO. By police officer also comes under POSCO Act. So in POSCO Act is actually protection of children from sexual offences. This protection of children from sexual offences Act 2012. According to it, offences against the children include penetrative and aggressive penetrative sexual assault, sexual and aggravated sexual assault, sexual harassment, and using child for prolonged purposes. So all these comes under the POSCO Act. Then next question. In a case of professional misconduct, patient records on demand should be provided within. When someone demands their records, they should be provided within 72 hours. There are even two important questions. OP records should be kept in the hospital till 5 years. Whereas inpatient records should be kept in a hospital for a period of 10 years. Inpatient records should be kept at a for a period of 10 years, whereas OP records should be kept at a for a period of 5 years. Then we have bullet fingerprinting. Bullet fingerprinting is based on secondary markings. Primary markings are common to the bullets which are manufactured by a particular manufacturer. But secondary markings are unique markings which are present uniquely for each of the bullet. So these secondary markings are important in bullet fingerprinting. Then next question. Identify the postmortem lividity of the image. You can see that this is postmortem lividity, which is bluish. Here you can see the bluish purple or purplish red discoloration of the skin is seen, and this is suggestive of postmortem hypostasis, also called as sugulation. It is suggestive of postmortem hypostasis, also called as sugulation. Then we have the next question. A female was found dead in her bathroom. The door room was not locked from inside. Blood volumes of alcohol is 350 milligram per deciliter. With the image of face, open neck and viscera, picture was taken of bruises on the neck and cyanosed lips. Dissected neck was showing soft tissue ecchymosis. Cause of death. I will show you the picture. This is the picture which is shown. See here, if you carefully observe, you can see these lines which you can see here. All these are the lines. Actually, these are the finger markings which are seen. Here, this patient has been dead due to the throttling of the neck. Someone has throttled her neck, and as a result, she has been dead. So, it is case of throttling. Then the next question. In the given image, the hands present with, this is with, present with hyperpigmentation. It occurs due to. So here you can see hyperpigmentation of hands, right? So why are these hands hyperpigmented? That is the question. So it is due to long-term administration of long-term administration of arsenic containing water will cause hyperpigmentation of the skin. If it is copper sulfate, you will see bluish green discoloration. You won't see brownish discoloration. In copper sulfate, you will see bluish green discoloration. So it is not copper sulfate. Mostly the discoloration of the skin is seen due to arsenic poisoning. Then, how many days a vaginal swab can be taken from a rape victim? A vaginal swab can be taken up to 4 days. Vaginal swab can be taken from a rape victim up to 4 days. Then next question. In case of concentric teeth bite mark on the forearm, what should be done next? Whenever there is a complete bite mark, first you will see complete description of the injury has to be seen. So in the bite mark investigation, first and foremost we should see the complete description of the injury. Afterwards we should take the photograph of the injury. Photograph should be taken. Then after taking the photograph, we should take the swab collection for saliva, for any saliva, for DNA estimation. We should take swab collection after photograph, and then impression of the bite mark should be obtained by a plaster of Paris or rubber or silicon based plastic substances. With that you can obtain the impression of bite mark by preparing a cast, negative cast for selection. So if we have to or put this in an order, first and foremost you will give complete description of the injury. You should give complete description of the injury. Second, keep scale for measuring the mark and take photo in the plane of the bite. Then third, swab collection should be taken. After swab collection, you should do prepare cast using vinyl polysiloxane. Right? Next question. 18-year-old girl brought to the OPD, labia majora are separated. Labia minora are flabby. Fourchette tear is present and vagina is roomy. Hymen is intact. What are the following? 18-year-old with labia majora separated, labia minora flabby, fourchette tear is present. Fourchette tear is present. So obviously these are false virgins. That is, these patients have had sexual experience but still sexual intercourse, but still the hymen is intact. So as a result they are false virgins. The next question. Identify the fracture given below. See, this is the fracture which is given below. You can see the fracture if I have to label it. See, there is fracture line here. There is fracture line here. So this fracture line is present around the foramen of magnum. It is present around the foramen of magnum across the middle cranial fossa. It is present across the middle cranial fossa and pituitary fossa, and through this the skull is divided into two. What is this type of fracture? This is actually a hinge fracture, which is seen in motor cyclist injury. So this is a hinge fracture in motor cyclist injury. Next question. Identify the lesion given below, given in the image below. See, this is the lesion which is given. You can see that the lesion is only the epidermis is involved, only the superficial layers of epidermis is involved, and you can see the grazing or impressions. So it is actually an abrasion. So this is an abrasion which is shown in the figure. Thank you for watching.